Stroman, I mentioned, you know, look, DeGrom being out now for the 10 days with the lat or whatever's going on there. You know, he's an interesting guy because he's a timing rhythm guy. And I watch him closely, guys. I know what he does on his side and his work. It is paint. And when I look at what he does, as I said, the highest ground ball rate of 59%, he's got two breaking balls that stay on the glove side. If you look at this right-handers, he's exceptional right here. Where you see McCann setting up away. That's actually the split finger where you're trying to get plate coverage down to either get a swing and a miss or even a good take. But the movement and the action, it's constantly, very seldom does he throw something straight. I know that little left center center field camera angle doesn't really do its justice with the ball constantly moving back and forth. But I just want to accentuate the point of, yes, he comes in periodically, but that two-seam comeback, Tom, what you just mentioned about that last at-bat, that was a flyout. This is where he perfects it. And he's got that ability to have that little cut on the cutter and then the sinker. That split changeup away from the lefty is really good. So the speed variation, but when you get to money where he wants in his back pocket, his ability to command and trust, it is a way. It's a way on the righty. He does have a nice sinker that he'll trust away to the lefty and that split finger that he struck out the lefty there. But the onus is really on Marcus Stroman. Him coming back, you look at the numbers, clearly what he's done since joining the Mets, it's much better. But what I find unique about him, and I know you got Cueto and he does the wiki, you know, I started looking into it more and more. I was like, there's something with this. This isn't just like some cool thing to do because it looks good on television. The timing of what you're trying to do or offset the timing of a hitter, that plays into it. And he's, you know, some guys I don't think are comfortable with it. Remember Batista, used to be with the Orioles. I'm blanking on his first name. He had the open stance. I know you're going to get it, Tom. And he used to wind up with you.
Toronto?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I would start, and I couldn't get this guy out. But you start and stop. You know, there's some effectiveness to that. And I think he utilizes that because he's not throwing 95 to 98 anymore. So that ability to change speeds and use four different pitches, he really is a pitcher. Mm-hmm. Doesn't walk anybody. Attacks the zone. He gets a lot of ground balls.
Well, as you know, he's a great athlete. So he's able to do things with his delivery besides what he does with the pitches, which really works to his advantage. That was a great breakdown. What I loved about that was when all many times that McCann would set the target outside the strike zone, because he wants Stroman to think about starting it outside the strike zone and bring it back. And as a catcher, you want to catch the ball coming into the zone. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to set up here and move your hand out of the zone.
Yes.
It's fascinating to see the target outside the zone, knowing that it's going to be here.
You know what?
But visually, for Stroman, start it on the outside and let it run back.
Great pickup. Because actually, when looking at the breakdown earlier from Brianna, who did it for me, I said, man, that's it's a 2-2 count. And where he sets up is actually a ball.
Yep.
And he does it on his slider as well. By the way, it was Tony Batista.
Batista.
Yeah. And he wind up with you. And I was like, wait a minute, I got to figure out a way to...